गोविंद गोपाल नंद दुलाल जय यशोदा दुलाल जय जय देव हरे राधे कृष्ण गोविंद गोपाल नंद दुलाल जय यशोदा कुच मंडला कृत कोंदरमरा कुच मंडला कृत कोंदर
त्रिभुवन भवन निधान जय जय देव हरे Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. प्रभु की।
शुद्ध गोस्वामी डूइंग प्रणाम ऑफरिंग हिज दंडवत प्रणाम टू हिज गुरुदेव बिकॉज ही इज गोइंग टू बिगिन श्रीमद भागवतम। ऑल्सो ही टेलिंग जन स्वान भाव मखिल सुखी सार दीप अध्यात्म दीपम अति तीर्थ शतांग समोन्द्र। और दिस श्रीमद भागवतम स्वानुभाव अखिल सुतिसार दिस इज द एब्स्ट्रैक्ट ऑफ होल वैदिक लिटरेचर पुराण एंड ऑल पुराण्स महाभारत रामायण गीता एवरीथिंग दिस इज द एसेंस एब्स्ट्रैक्ट ऑफ दि श्रीमद भागवत। इट इज ऑल्सो ए प्रदीप लाइक लैंप by lamp in the darkness we see something to us also and others also. So Srimad Bhagavatam by reading, by following Srimad Bhagavatam, by hearing from any bona fide guru, he can see transcendental Krishna, his associates and his sweet pastimes. So samsarina karuna ah Vyasadeva taught his son Pav with Karuna and also with a great mercy to world these living entities, my Gurudev, Sukadeva Goswami. Out of mercy he has told this Srimad Bhagavatam. So we should hear Srimad Bhagavatam. Shortly we should hear that. And then he began to Srimad Bhagavatam. समय पुंसान परो धर्मो जतो भक्ति रथो खजे अहे तो कप प्रतिरथा जय आत्मा संप्रसिद्धि। ओ यू एंड ऑल्सो यू शुड एक्सप्लेन अंडा विराजता
यू शुड ट्राई टू बी परीक्षित महाराज वाट dying after 7 days and he forget to take anything, water even, no prasadam, no water, no sleeping, day and night harikatha shravan. And only in 7 days he left his body without any suffering and went to Golok Vrindavan. So you should try to hear like Sukadeva.
ओमतिरंदस्य ज्ञानंजनाशलाकय चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। गुरवे गौरचंद्राय राधिकाय तदालये कृष्णाय कृष्णभक्ताय तद्भक्ताय नमो नमः। श्रीकृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासरी गौर भक्त हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई एम ऑफरिंग माय दंडवत प्रणाम्स एंड माय श्रद्धा पुष्पांजलि टू द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय बिलोवेड दीक्षा गुरुदेव नित्यलीला प्रविष्ट ओम विष्णुपाद अष्टोत्तर सत श्री शील A.C. Bhakti Vedanta Swami Maharaj Prabhupada. And secondly, I'm offering my equal Dandavat Pranams and Shodha Pushpanjali to the lotus feet of my beloved Siksha Gurudevs, Nityalila Pravishta Om Vishnu Padshri Shila Bhakti Rakshak Sridhara Goswami Maharaj and Om Vishnu Pad Ashto Tarasata Shri Shila Bhakti Vedanta Narayan Goswami Maharaj, our beloved Srila Gurudev. And to all of the Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis, friends and guests, all the Chidandi Sannyasikan, my Dandavat Pranams. We are very fortunate to be hearing this introduction to the most glorious literature on the surface of the earth planet, titled Srimad Bhagavatam. And Srila Gurudev has kindly given us this synopsis of the introduction, actually bringing us to that very place. Here, he is sitting as the representative of the author of Srimad Bhagavatam, Srila Vyasadeva. And he is seated here before us on this Vyasasana. And he is disseminating this very same message that has been broadcast down through the ages for more than 5,000 years. We are hearing this divine message of Srimad Bhagavatam, the most potent spiritual topics that exist on our earth planet today, by hearing which any living being may attain the highest perfection of human form of life. So, in this introduction to Srimad Bhagavatam, Srila Gurudev has been narrating the various personalities who are the speakers of this great message of Srimad Bhagavatam. And the questions that were asked by the great learned sages, more than 80,000 sages present there. And they're asking relevant questions. How a human being may become actually perfectly happy in his soul. Not on the bodily level, on the level of this material body, senses and mind, but on the level of the eternal Atma. Atma means self or soul. So the questions the sages were asking was, what is the highest activity that performing any person, any human being, he may become completely Atma Sampraciditi, perfectly happy. So, in response to this, Sri Suta Goswami, the chief speaker in this assembly, he stated, Savaipung Saparu Dharmo, Yato Bhaktir Adhokshaje, Ahai Tuki Apratihata, Ye Atma Sampraciditi. Savaipung Samparo Dharmo. He immediately went straight to the point and he said, the topmost, supreme, paradharma, supreme activity that any human being may perform, it is called bhakti, pure devotional love. Bhakti, the activity of bhakti performed toward adhokshaja. Adhokshaja means the absolute supreme truth, the supreme reality, the supreme personality of Godhead, Bhagavan, Sri Krishna, who is the creator of the creators of these material universes and planets. And he is the source of everything that exists. And he exists himself far beyond the range of our mind, intelligence, and senses. That personality of Godhead is adhoksaja, because no one is equal to or greater than him. Everyone is subordinate to him. And that personality cannot be approached by our demands, nor we can demand that he should come down to our level. But by performance of bhakti to that divine personality, which type of bhakti it must be? Ahaituki bhakti. It must be devoid of any other motivations other than his happiness, to please him. Ahaituki. And apratihata. It must not be interrupted by anything. Not that we will do it one day a week, 1 hour a week, or that periodically at any time we may do some activity of bhakti. But here Suta Goswami very carefully explained, it must be apratihata. It must be uninterrupted. That activity must be constantly going on 24 hours daily. And when that activity is performed by the Atma, by the soul, by the human being who has attained this human birth and is now has the capability to render pure devotional activities to the Supreme Being, what becomes the result of that? Ye Atma Sampraciditi. Here, Atma, some precedency has two meanings. It means, Atma means the Supreme Self, the Supreme Absolute Personality. That is God, that is Krishna. When he becomes fully satisfied by the rendering of pure bhakti, then automatically the individual Atma, that is ourself, the tiny spirit souls within this world who are part and parcel of the Supreme Being, when that pure bhakti is rendered to the Supreme Being and he becomes satisfied, automatically we become satisfied. Just like if you pour water on the root of a tree, automatically the branches, the leaves of the tree, every single part of that tree receives the benefit of the water because it is given to the root. So the root of all living beings, we have all eternal connection with the Supreme Absolute Being, Bhagavan Sri Krishna. When pure devotional bhakti, bhakti yoga is rendered to him, then automatically we receive the benefit. It is distributed to ourselves and to all living beings. So how to understand this bhakti yoga process? How to properly perform this bhakti yoga process? Oh, our great acharyas in our line, coming down for thousands of years to the time of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is an incarnation of Krishna in this Kali Yuga age. He taught to his most dear disciple, Srila Rupa Goswami Pad, and Srila Rupa Goswami Pad conveyed these teachings of Bhakti Yoga to the entire world in his literature titled Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. And there Srila Rupa Goswami explained what is the definition of bhakti, so that we may know how to do bhakti and how to avoid something which is not performing bhakti. So therefore he described, what is bhakti? Anya vilashita shunyam jnana karmadi anavritam anakulyena krishnanu shilanam bhaktir uttama. Here he is described uttama bhakti. Uttama bhakti means pure devotion, pure bhakti, which is untinged by anything else. It is the topmost form of bhakti. Just like, if you ask for water, what are you asking for? You are asking for pure water. You don't want water adulterated by anything else. So similarly, the understanding of what is pure devotion, uttama bhakti, that is being described here. First of all, he explains, anya vilashita shunyam, that if one is doing pure bhakti, it will be completely devoid of any other desire.
We begin from ankulena krishna anushilan, then come to this point.
Okay.
What is bhakti and then uttama bhakti? In two sentences afterwards.
So in this verse, it is divided into two parts. And the second part is describing the principal symptom of bhakti. So there, that symptom is described as anukulyena krishna anushilanam. Anukul means favorable. Favorable cultivation. Anushilanam. Anushilanam means that with one's mind, one's body, one's words, and even one's emotions constantly flowing in this performance of activities that are favorable and pleasing to Krishna, and are flowing just like an unbroken stream of honey. This is the main symptom of bhakti. So that bhakti, which is constantly being performed for the happiness of Krishna, it must also have the external symptoms, the secondary symptoms.
More thing. What is the meaning? Anu. And then Shilanam. You should describe all these things. Anu means? Varan Nairantarya. And in the guidance of Guru and Vaishnava. And what is favorable and not favorable by the example of Yashoda Maiya and Charan Goswami, all Yashoda speak.
So, Nairantarya means constantly flowing, uninterrupted flow. So, anushilanam refers to this word anu. Anu means constantly under guidance of Sri Guru, a perfected, realized spiritual master. Under his guidance, performing these activities constantly and not, with no interruption. Now, there are a couple of examples to make clear this understanding. What is actually pleasing to Krishna, performance in the category of performing bhakti. Now, we know that when Bhagavan Sri Krishna came into the wrestling arena of Kamsa, at that time, there were two very powerful wrestlers, Chanur and Mushtika. These two wrestlers, they had an order and a desire to kill Krishna. That was their motivation. So, Krishna and his friends came into the wrestling arena, and actually, they were happy. They wanted to engage in wrestling, because in the forest of Vrindavan, the cowherd boys and Krishna would often wrestle. And this playful activity in friendship gave great happiness and pleasure to Krishna. So in this wrestling arena, they were also entering, and they were thinking, oh, this will be a very fun activity. We will wrestle. So then, when Krishna began to wrestle with these wrestlers, Krishna and Balaram were wrestling with Chanur and Mushtika. And Chanur and Mushtika were constantly pounding Krishna, and they were locking each other in very powerful locks, wrestling locks. And in this way, Krishna and Balaram were sporting and fighting with Chanur and Mushtika. And Krishna was feeling great happiness, actually, because he was tasting rasa. He was tasting vira ras, chivalry, and sporting. But Chanur and Mushtika, their whole motivation was that Krishna should be killed. So, can we say that Chanur and Mushtika were doing bhakti to Krishna? Because definition of bhakti is anukulyena, favorable for Krishna's happiness. But in this regard, they were not favorable to Krishna's happiness because they wanted to kill Krishna. So we cannot confuse the definition here by taking this statement of anukul and applying it to Chanur and Mushtika. Now, on the other hand, we see that in the case of Mother Yashoda, Mother Yashoda, naturally, her whole existence is given to Krishna for Krishna's pleasure as his mother. Every single thing she does, every thought she has, is to give happiness to Krishna. But we see that when Mother Yashoda was breastfeeding Krishna, and the milk that was left on the stove was boiling over. And when Mother Yashoda saw it boiling over, and suddenly she began to rush toward the stove to save the milk from boiling over, she had to quickly put Krishna down. And when she put Krishna down, oh, Krishna was upset. Oh, Mother Yashoda has stopped giving me her breast milk. And he was very upset, like a small child will be upset. And then he went down from the bed and began to do some mischief. We know that whole story of Damodar Leela. So Mother Yashoda, she made Krishna upset. So can we say that she was doing bhakti to Krishna? Because she did not give direct happiness to Krishna? No, we cannot. Because Mother Yashoda's every activity was for Krishna. The purpose of the milk was for making milk sweets so that Krishna would become happy, completely satisfied by these milk sweets. And that she was also engaging the milk in the activity of serving Krishna. So in this way, Mother Yashoda was performing bhakti. So anukul, anukulyena Krishna anushilanam, means constantly serving Krishna with the attitude that Krishna will be pleased, Krishna will be happy by this activity. So in the other side of this definition, there is the understanding of what bhakti is not. And here it says, anya abhilashita shunyam. This means that if one is performing actual bhakti as given here, then he will also not have any other abhilas, desires. No other desires other than to please Krishna. In other words, one's entire existence of body, mind, words, emotions, everything will constantly be absorbed in Krishna with no other types of desires impeding that flow. And
Anadyabhilashita shunyam jnana karmadi anavritam. And also Rupa Goswami.
Why it has been told anabhilashita?
Yes. So
why? Yes. Why not anabhilash?
So in anabhilashita shunyam, there is the extra syllables ita. So here, Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur has explained that this indicates that a devotee in normal circumstances, oh, he will have no other desires other than performing bhakti to Krishna. He will not approach Krishna for fulfilling his desires. But in an extraordinary circumstance, like an emergency case where death may be coming suddenly, oh, then at that time, the devotee may call out for Krishna. And, oh, Krishna, save me. So Srila Rupa Goswami has placed this syllable here to understand explicitly that bhakti will not be harmed in that circumstance. Why? Because it is natural for the devotee. It is completely natural for him to be fully dependent on Krishna in every time, place, and circumstance. So when such emergency is coming, then the devotee completely depends and calls out for Krishna. So therefore, it will not be covered. Like in the case of Draupadi. Draupadi was so devoted to Krishna. But when Dushasan was trying to disrobe her in the assembly of the Kauravas, at that time, she was attempting to hold on to her sari, but he was overpowering her. And at that time, she called out and raised her hands in the air, O Krishna, O Krishna. And Krishna himself responded by becoming unlimited amounts of sari. So in that situation, it is still pure bhakti, it is not harmed. So, anyabhilashita shunyam, jnana karmadi anavritam. And also bhakti will not be covered. Bhakti will not be covered over by the process of developing jnana. Jnana means that one is trying to engage in developing impersonal knowledge of impersonal liberation, merging into the Supreme. Like there are many Mayavadis, many impersonalists, and they believe that the Atma can merge into the Supreme Atma and lose his own individual spiritual existence for eternity. So this kind of development of jnana, tending toward impersonal liberation, oh, this will cover bhakti. And similarly, karma. Karma means selfish, sense-gratificatory, seeking activities. That one is interested and one is performing bhakti in order to attain material happiness within this world, on this material level, or even in higher planets of this material universe, like heavenly planets, Swargalok, and so forth. This will also cover bhakti. And also activities of yoga, whereby a person practices mystic yoga, ashtanga yoga, and their intention is to develop the mystic siddhis, or powers, very subtle powers by which they can manipulate material nature. So this will also cover bhakti. So here Rupa Goswami has explained so clearly what bhakti, what pure bhakti consists of, and what are the activities that will be opposed to bhakti, that will negate the effects of bhakti. So, in this assembly, in Naimisharanya Forest, Srila Suta Goswami has given that also this very clear declaration that it is only by the performance of pure bhakti, ahoitukiya pratihata, which is never motivated by any other activity and is uninterrupted flow for the pleasure of Krishna, this alone will satisfy the Supreme Lord, and the soul will be completely satisfied by this. So this is the purport of this verse, Savaipam Samparo Dharma.
Very good explanation. If you want to know more detail, you should read Bhakti Rasami Sindhu Bindu. And there Vishwanath, you must read. Then systematic way you can express all this. Pravritti mulak, vritti mulak, there are so many things to tell. Anukulya means those who are favorable. But those who are not favorable, wish to
reject
all. And those who are favorable for Krishna, not only to please, both things, to please Krishna and for the benefit of Krishna, whether Krishna is waiting or not. This is pure bhakti. You should know that this bhakti covers from lust his part from shraddha.
Last fraction
of bhakti, that is shraddha. What is shraddha? Shraddha, though it has been told, Krishna bhakti, if you are doing, your life is successful. But the two desire to suffer Krishna, this desire is really shraddha. And from where it will come, and this desire is transcendental. It will only come by sadhu sangha, by Gurudev. By mercy of Krishna, it will come in his associates, and from there, it will come in the heart of Krishna. And then outer symptom will be, oh, he will have so much strong faith in Krishna words, epic words, Srimad Bhagavat words, and Guru words. If he has no faith in epics, then no Shraddha. No, if he has no strong faith in his Guru word, no Shraddha. Even no faith in Krishna words, what he has told in Gita and especially in Bhagavad, then not Shraddha. After that, Shraddha, second association of Bhakta. Then he realizes that Guru is needed. Without Guru, we cannot enter in the realm of Bhakti. So must we should take initiation from any bona fide in the form of cheaters, thousand and thousand. Oh, gurus are here and there in this world. They are cheating others. They make disciples only for wealth. But they cannot remove the doubts of and also ignorance of devotees, and they cannot put bhakti in their hearts. So we should be careful for that. And then Guru Karan and 10 primary anga of symptom of bhakti. Guru Padrasya, Guru Sicha taking from Gurudev, Vishambhena Guru survive all these things. Without Guru serving, Tadvidhi Paripatena Pariparasneena Sevaya. Without serving Gurudev, oh, if you will hear no fruit, so we should serve him, obey him. And then Nishtha, after that, Ruchi, and then Asakti comes. And after Asakti, oh, Shuddha Sattva, Rati will come. Rati is transcendental. So, bhakti are of two kinds. One is Bali bhakti, and second is Raganuga bhakti. Bhakti, first we should begin from Bali bhakti. But by hearing the sweet pastimes of Krishna from any bona fide guru or sadhu, if you have lobh, greed to serve Krishna like Sudama, Sridham, Madhumangal, Subal, like Nandbaba Yashoda Maiya, and more than that, like gopis. And more, to be the palyadasi of Srimati Radhika, like Manjari. So, gradually it comes. Also, this bhakti is the service of Radhika to Krishna. And that is highest in prem, sneha, man, pranay, rag, anurag, bhav, mahabhav, adhirud, rud, adhirud, modan, and then madanakya. Mahabhav up to mahabhav in all gopis. Some partly in Dwarkapuri also something. Queens of Dwarka, Satyabhama Rukmini. But after Mahabhav, Rud, Adhirud, not in anyone. And moreover, Mohan also, it may be in Chandravali and others. Moreover, that, what?
Madanakka Mahabhav.
No, before. In Mohan, all other things. It may be like in Yashoda and other songs, and Yashoda, Lalita, Vishakha. But this Madanakya Bhav, not in Chandravali, not even in Lalita, Vishakha, and even.
Monopoly of Radhika.
Only it be when Krishna or Radhika are sitting together, but by thinking, they are thinking, they say, where is Krishna? Where is Krishna, Radhika? So, he began to lament, where? So, this is Madanakya Bhav, not in any other. So, up to this, bhakti covers. In this way, I was going to tell that bhakti is of two kinds, Vaidhi bhakti and Raganuga. What is Vaidhi bhakti? Yatra ragan anuvapta pravikti rupajayate sasnen eva sastasya sa Vaidhi bhakti ki ruchyata. Nowadays, especially in European countries, Russian